Yeah, my name's Noel. I'm a psychotherapist. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Do subscribe while you're here. If you're watching this on my website, please enter in your details into the dialogue box above and put in your email address, and I'll add you to the email list and send you these blogs or vlogs on a regular basis. So this short video today on sort of how to set healthy boundaries. Boundaries define what happens between people. Sort of they define where I begin and end and where you begin and end, what I'm responsible for, what I like and don't like, what you're responsible for, what you like and don't like, our communication styles, physical contact styles, all of those types of things. And boundaries differ from relationship to relationship. So the boundaries I have with a boss, for example, may not involve much physical contact, whereas the boundaries I have with my children may involve a lot of physical contact, depending on their age. So with young children, I'll be holding them and hugging them and playing with them and tickling them. I wouldn't be doing that with my boss. And it's obvious to say that, isn't it? And I suppose that's the point I want to make, that if we become more aware of these types of boundaries, the rules that govern our interaction, then we can become clearer about setting healthier ones with people. So in abusive relationships, we may become able to set rules which say that people can't talk to us in a certain way, or that if they do, we'll leave, or people won't hit us, and so on and so forth. So those are what we mean by boundaries. They're the rules of engagement, if you like. So how do we set healthy boundaries? First thing is to recognise that we need them, and to think about them, do some reading, maybe go and see a therapist like myself and talk about what boundaries are. It very much depends on how you're brought up. In some people brought up with very healthy boundary setting, where these types of things were talked about a lot in the family, and were negotiated. And ultimately and ideally, boundaries between people are something that are negotiated as much as possible. Some people were brought up in households where there were no boundaries at all, or some people were brought up in households where there were incredibly strict and almost crushing boundaries. Everything was controlled by one of the parents. So that's the sort of broad range of experiences that people come from. So I suppose the first thing you need to know about setting healthy boundaries is that you have to give yourself permission to do it. You're allowed to do it. Boundaries are necessary and important in every single relationship. Without boundaries, there is no relationship to speak of. And knowing what constitutes a healthy or unhealthy boundary for yourself is really important. Don't set weak boundaries. Lacking clarity in your boundaries or being inconsistent in them leads to low self-esteem. We know it's associated with low self-esteem and low self-respect. As well as the fact that somebody may take advantage of you. But you will ultimately end up disliking yourself for it and not understanding that. So setting healthy, clear boundaries with another person will improve your self-esteem and your self-respect. Talk about your feelings with yourself and other people. Get to know your feelings about situations that you're involved with. If you don't like them, think about whether you've got correct boundaries. So trust those feelings. There may be a gut instinct there somewhere. If you're having a lot of resentment about things, it's often a sign that you're not asserting your boundaries and not being clear. Anger is a healthy emotion. Resentment isn't necessarily such a healthy emotion. Anger expressed appropriately, assertively, is about setting boundaries, about saying, no, I don't like that. Actually, please don't do that. And the capacity to assert and use that feeling of no or anger in an appropriate way is absolutely life-saving. Not saying that leads to a lot of resentment, as I've said, and that can lead to passive-aggressive communication where suddenly you're just explosively angry with somebody. Again, that can be very undermining to your own self-esteem if you behave in a way that you don't like about yourself. So think about your feelings, what's going on. Don't be hesitant about saying what you want to somebody. So learn skills of communicating these issues verbally. And don't think you have to get it right all the time. You don't. Like I say, boundaries are negotiated, and it's sometimes an ongoing conversation. You may try something out and find that it doesn't work for you in that particular relationship. But that's okay. You can get things wrong. You can try again. If we don't get things wrong in life, it means we're not really living. So give it a go. Talk about stuff. If you're in a relationship where this stuff can't be talked about, ask yourself some serious questions about that relationship. Do you need help within the relationship? Do you need couple counselling? Or do you need to leave? That may be a serious question that you need to ask yourself. So don't be hesitant about speaking up for yourself. Get to know yourself. Try different boundaries in different situations. Maybe join a few groups and see what it's like. You can go and join a cuddle group. They exist. And find out what that's like. Do you actually like being cuddled by strangers or not? You may not. That's how you find out. You go and try stuff out. So give it a go. Experiment. Talk to people. Get some literature on the subject. There's plenty of literature around. Talk to a therapist about it. And don't set boundaries that are either too relaxed or too rigid. I use these sort of 30-70 rules. So if you think of things on a spectrum between 0 and 100, 0 would be almost no boundaries. 100 would be boundaries that are crushing and controlling. And really you want to be somewhere 30-70 in most things. So 30%, 70%, and that gives you room for manoeuvre. You don't want to try and be 50-50 all the time, because that's a very sort of narrow tightrope to walk. So somewhere in between 30 and 70. So not zero, no boundaries, not 100, which is a prison. Somewhere in between that is healthy and gives yourself room for manoeuvre. I hope that's been helpful. If you're having issues around boundaries and you don't know what they are, you don't know what sort of boundaries you'd like, if you're finding that people are taking advantage of you or that you're overly controlling of other people because you're not comfortable in your own skin, do give me a call. Maybe I can help you out. It's 07-506-319-745. That's 07-506-319-745. Or email me info@noelmcdermott.co.uk. That's info@noelmcdermott.co.uk. Thanks for dropping by, and I hope I'll see you again. Bye-bye.